बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, वेलकम टू ITFS Solutions। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट SQL null functions। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज़ द यूज़ केस वेयर वी नीड दीज SQL null functions। सो इफ़ यू रिमेंबर वी हैव प्रोडक्ट्स टेबल इन अवर डेटाबेस वी हैव क्रिएटेड अर्लियर। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सेलेक्ट ऑल फ्रॉम प्रोडक्ट्स। So execute this one. Look at this, we have two records in the products table. One is a mobile and its quantity is null, and another one is the one is a laptop and another one is mobile and its quantity is 50. Let's say we have use case display the available stock. Okay, so select quantity from products, execute this one. Look at this, we have this null over here. Let's say I only want to select quantity of product where name equals to laptop. Okay, click on this one and execute this one. Look at this, we have null over here. To avoid this null, because a lot of time when we are performing calculations in our store procedures, we need some calculations. So let's say I want to display the price of laptops multiplied by quantity. So it will ignore the actual price because of this quantity. Okay, so in these scenarios we should use null functions. SQL is null function. Okay, so how to use this one? You will simply write is null. Okay, and then you will use these parentheses, and this is our column name where we want to check is null, and then comma, this is the returned expression. Okay, so I will write zero. It will look up into this column. If this column is null, then this expression will be returned, otherwise this column is simply returned. So if you execute this one, look at this, we have zero, and for sure you should add alias for this column because we are using function over here, quantity. Okay, now select this one, execute. Look at this, we have zero over here. Now execute this one. Look at this, we have 50 quantity for mobiles. So let's make sure for mobiles. Click on this one. We copy this one and paste it over here and reset it as laptop. Okay, now execute these both. Let's make sure the name of product, this is not mobile, this is mobile. Okay, now select this one, execute. Look at this, this will check this column is null, then it will return zero, as you can see over here, zero. You can simply write an alias laptop quantity and then mobile quantity. Okay, now execute this one. Look at this, we have laptop quantity is null, then it will return this zero, and we have mobile quantity as 50, then this column will be returned and this expression, this return statement or returned value will be ignored. So this is how you can use SQL null, and this is very useful. Let's say you want to set your own increment logic for a table. So if your table doesn't have any record, then what should you do? Let's create a variable, declare serial. I will write this as serial and it's of type int. Okay, so let's click on edit and then remove this one values from here. Okay, and let's say I want to make an ID column auto increment. So this is our product ID. Okay, so I will set at serial equals to 1. I don't need to set this one because I will be using this is null statement. Okay, so let's say if is null, you can use this is null with anyone. And what is null? Product ID, and then I will return 1 as an let's say it select is null product ID comma 0 from here. Okay, from products. Now first execute this one. Look at this, we are not getting any columns name product ID because we don't have any record in this table. So should I do, should I add another record in this table? Test product. Okay, so now execute this one. Look at this, we have product ID 0. Then you can set this product ID to this variable, set equals to this, and this will set, remove this one from here, and this will set 0 to this serial. Okay, then you can simply check if at serial equals to 0, then begin and set serial equals to 1. Okay, now click on end. Else you can simply, you can, don't need to set else over here because we are setting this from here. Okay, so this is how you can use is null function, and it is very useful function in terms of performing calculations or returning data from table. Instead of returning null, you should return 0 or something else. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please share this video with your friends and on your social media accounts so those guys can also learn SQL concepts. We'll meet again in the next video. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum.